Hello friend, today we are going to discuss on dividend payout ratio. We are at a Wall Street Mojo site and this is designed by Dheeraj Vaidya. So basically, let's describe what is dividend payout ratio. The dividend payout ratio is the amount of dividends paid to stockholders relative to the amount of total net income of a company. The amount that is not paid out in dividends to stockholders is held by the company for growth. The amount that is kept by the company is called retained earnings, right? So in this dividend payout ratio graph, we can see that the Colgate dividend comes out to 61.78. Okay, so 61.78% is the dividend payout ratio for Colgate. And for other company, that is Amazon, Google and Berkshire Hathaway, has a 0% dividend payout ratio. So you will see this straight line which shows there is a 0% dividend payout ratio, which means dividend is not paid out to the stockholders. So in this, the dividend payout ratio is an indicator, is an important indicator of how a company is doing financially. As we note from above, Colgate dividend payout ratio was 61.78%. in 2016-17. However, Amazon, Google and Berkshire Hathaway haven't paid a penny to the shareholders via dividend, right? Now, based on this concept, we will have a numerical example. We will see how this dividend payout ratio works and we will do the analysis on the same. So in this dividend payout ratio, we are going to discuss in brief what exactly dividend payout ratio means. Does the dividend payout ratio say anything about the growth of the company? And how would you compute a dividend payout ratio? This is what we are going to discuss today. So let's try and understand first what is the dividend payout ratio more in brief. So a dividend payout ratio is the percentage of a company's earning that it pays out to investor in the form of dividends. It is calculated by dividing dividends paid during a period by net earnings for that period. Dividend payout ratio is a reciprocal of retention ratio, which measures the percentage of earnings of a company reinvest in a project to generate a future growth. So we have an example over here. Okay. So the dividend payout, we will work on this example. So the dividend payout ratio is an important indicator of a company's performance from an investor point of view. Okay. So the formula for dividend payout ratio is dividend payout ratio equals to dividend paid by net income, right? So that is the formula. So we have a formula for a dividend payout ratio, that is dividend paid by net income or dividend per share by earnings per share. And the other formula we have is the dividend ratio formula, that is 1 minus retention ratio, right? So as mentioned above, dividend is one portion of the profit. Another portion is the company keeps for reinvesting into the expansion of a company is called retained earnings. And when we compute the percentage of retained earnings out of net income, we would get retention ratio. So the retention ratio equals to retained earnings by net income, right? So if you know the net income and retained earnings, you would easily be able to find out the dividend ratio of a company, if any. Just deduct the retained earnings from the net income and divide the figure by net income and you will get the dividend payout ratio. So we have discussed this formula. Let's see what information we have for the numerical example. So here we have an example based on the information given below. We will calculate and analyze the dividend payout ratio for ABC Incorporated and XYZ Corporation. So all the amounts are in USD dollars. So people invest in a company expecting a return on their investment, which comes from two sources. One is the capital gains and other is dividend. The return from these two sources is interrelated. A high dividend payout ratio means that company is reinvesting less earnings in future project, which in turn means less capital gain in future periods. Similarly, low payout ratio today may result in a higher capital gain in future. Some investors prefer companies that provide high potential for capital gains, while others prefer companies that pay high dividend. Dividend payout ratio helps each class of investor identify which company to invest in. A dividend payout ratio also provides an indication of a company's future growth potential for investors that are interested in a high growth companies. High dividend payout ratio may not be a good sign. Dividend payout ratio should be analyzed in the context of industry and other ratios such as dividend yield ratio or PE ratio, that is price earning ratio. Okay, so we have the information based on ABC and XYZ company. Both are NYSE listed company. ABC is a technology based company and XYZ is an oil and gas company. So as you can see, in 2011, no dividend was paid out to the shareholder by ABC company, and in later years in 2012, 13 and 14, they paid the dividend. Similarly, XYZ, they paid the dividend throughout the year. Okay, and this information that we have, that is the dividend and net income, is the crucial information to calculate the dividend payout ratio. Okay, so based on the information, we have calculated the dividend payout ratio. Okay, so this is the information that we had for 4 years. Okay, so the industry wise, we have calculated the dividend for 2011 till 2014. 0% was in 2011. Let's see the calculation. So what we did is dividend paid by net income. Dividend paid by net income gives you 0%. 6% was in 2012, 29% in 2013, and 28% in 2014. That's how we have done the calculation. Similarly, XYZ, we did the same calculations based on the formulas. Okay. So it was dividend paid by net income, right? It is 22%, 22% in 11 and 12, 33% in 13, and 36% in 2014, right? That is dividend by net income. So let's interpret what does this figures means, right? So let's first interpret about the ABC. So ABC did not pay dividend in 2011 because the management believed that the higher return for investors can be achieved if the earnings generated are reinvested in projects that will generate future growth. This is supported by the company's exceptional revenue growth in 2012. However, during the period from 2012 till 2014, the company's cash pile was way above the level needed to avail the feasible new projects. So the management paid generous dividends in these years. However, in case of technology company, high dividend payouts are an exceptional and not a rule, right? So this is a technology based. So let's see what interpretation we have for XYZ, which is an oil and gas. Okay, so the XYZ corporation, on the other hand, is in a mature industry, which is expected to maintain a steady dividend payout and even increase it over periods. So XYZ payout ratio has over in the range of 23% to 36% in 4 years, which is pretty stable, right? So that's how we complete the calculation and the interpretation part for the dividend payout ratio.